this is the first time I've ever come to something like this and spoken to someone like you. And before I get to my direct question, I want to tell you, coming from my political ignorance, it's all just been so overwhelming to try and understand it all. When I have heard or read snippets of what you're trying to do and the way you're trying to do it, I feel proud to have you representing me. I don't know how many politicians I can say that about, but I feel like I can trust you, and for me that's a big deal. I'm glad that some other people also have been thinking about what I've been thinking. I too work for the City of Los Angeles, so I too have to deal with the retirement Social Security offset thing. My question specifically for you today is, this also affects my job, addressing the conflict between the state legislation passed regarding use of marijuana, specifically medical, and the conflict that creates, because there's still a higher level, still considered illegal by the federal government. And all the research that I have seen and all the history that I've taught myself about, it tells me that it's time for the current status of marijuana to be changed, that its current status is now obsolete. And until it becomes decriminalized and put on the same level of alcohol, which is proven to be more harmful than marijuana, people like me will continue to be at risk with their employers if, God forbid, they should find out that we have a prescription for medical marijuana for qualifying conditions. I have actually three. And I would like to know that I could go to my job and not be afraid of being fired because I'm doing something that my state says is okay for my health, which, by the way, I only do after I get home from work. But that I do, because I know that it impairs me enough to where I can't do it before or during the day. But where if my employer found out, I would be instantly fired because there's no evaluating the situation.
Let me address the question. Your question illustrates what a complex structure of government we have in the United States. I'm here as a federal officer where the federal government may affect what the state government has done, and you're worried that the city will be inconsistent with the state or that the federal government may be inconsistent with the state. I agree with you that marijuana should not be, I believe it's called a Schedule 3. I believe it should be lowered one notch. The effect of that will be to inform the Attorney General that the state of California has a system for dealing with medical marijuana, and he ought to respect that system. I'm a representative. This state has voted for medical marijuana, and I go to Washington trying to defend the state's right to do so. At the same time, I'm not sure we all voted to have as many marijuana dispensaries as Starbucks. So the first place the city should get involved is with zoning and permitting and land use planning. Now you're in a unique circumstance because the city is your employer. And I have not thought until this moment, I certainly thought about medical marijuana versus the federal government. As to whether the city of Los Angeles can, for certain positions, require that somebody be marijuana free, I haven't thought of that at all. And in my doubt, I have no idea what your job is. If you're running the orange line, I might have a different view. Nor have I studied impairment issues as compared with testing issues, as compared with job performance. I'm not a safety engineer. So I wish I could tell you, I know this quantity of marijuana will stay in your system for this amount of time, and if we do this kind of test, we can know that you aren't impaired at this particular time for doing this particular job, and there are 500 different city jobs, and I don't have an opinion on any one of them. What I not be at the highest schedule.